The major downside to relying on that test is that you are using resistive properties as a predictor on whether or not when a person walks on the floor, they'll generate a static charge. Now, we measure static charges in volts, not ohms. So right away, we're using a test that measures a different property using different unit of measurement to predict a property that kind of has nothing to do with resistance. And I guess the way we want to describe this as it played out, we would often see conductive floors, which measure less than 1 megohm, in any location on the floor, whether it was an epoxy floor or, I don't know, whatever the type of floor the client might have. But under certain circumstances, even though the floor measured in the conductive range, when a person would walk on the floor with their ESD footwear, they would generate, in some cases, hundreds or even over 1,000 volts of static electricity.